Welcome back. Today I'm going to cover a positive success story that's happened recently, and it's almost like the Muslim Merchant series, but it's just started, so I want to cover it now, and then sometime down the line go revisit it again and show you how well it's done. The rapper Rimzee, a lot of people might know, you might not know, Rimzee from London, now you could say he's a musician / businessman, entrepreneur, different descriptions, but we'll go with the rapper for now. It's been well documented that he's been involved in let's say the roads, as many people would call it, that sort of stuff, being out there doing certain things, getting up to things, etc. And that's been there. Then he was jailed a few years back, or quite a few years back, and he's done his jail sentence, and when he's come out, with a different mindset to make up for lost time, to try and make the best of what he's got, make things happen, to make businesses and create money for him and people around him, and there was an interview that he did with Raheem from CEO Cost, where kind of go watch it, but it's like he has a vision of like creating multiple businesses and owning stuff, where if you need a whatever you need, he's got it, so it's all owned in-house, so if you need something you come to here, or if you need that you come to here, instead of other people overcharging you, here is reasonable, and it's all from your own people, and he's had a vision to do that, and he's even, I think recently he bought a property as well, and they do good stuff, and that podcast will tell you a lot more about it, an interview with Raheem from CEO Cost. But I want to highlight that from the road, then to jail, and then out of jail, all of this positivity, and now he's open a restaurant, or restaurant I'd say, or kind of like a takeaway or whatever, I'm not quite sure. It's called Burgers and Bagels, and I think it's Fulham Broadway, but I'm not certain, but I think it's Fulham Broadway. And you can see that a lot of people, they go to jail, and then when they come out, they go back to the same, because they haven't really, because they've been to jail, if they're trying to get jobs or whatever, it's difficult, and they do what they know best, which is go back to what led them to jail, like the same cycle, but not the case here. Another example I can quickly reference is Bobby Kasanga, went to jail, and then the same entire to come out, trying to do something positive, so it can be done. And here we see that it's been done, something positive, and you don't expect it, but if you come out of jail with the right mindset, with the right people around you, so that you don't go back to where you were, then you can have legal things, you can have legal money coming in. You don't have to worry, you can do what other people are doing. Just because you have to do the jail, then you can't. this is a positive example, and I want to highlight it. But it's not a Muslim merchant story, because later on down the line, we see the even more successful place that I'll revisit it then through a full Muslim merchant episode. But it was a